Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Being a Programmer. I am Rajashree and today we have to see views in your plsql. So in previous video we can see what is the introduction to your plsql language, what are the data types present in that, as well as what is the code structure of your plsql, what is stored function, what are the control statements, loops in your plsql, what is assignment operator, select into clause, and many more. So if you don't watch that video, a playlist is available in description box. So without any further ado, let's quickly get today's video, which is depends upon views concept. So let's start. So first of all, what is meant by view? So views are also known as logical table or virtual table. So why we call views a logical table or a virtual table? So first of all, tell me one thing. In your database, you can create multiple tables, and those multiple tables are stored in your database or in your memory. And that's why this is those tables are physical entity, right? Another example, we can live on Earth. So we can occupy some space. So we are a physical entity. So anything which occupies some space is a physical entity, and that's why table are known as physical entity. But views are known as logical entity or logical table or your virtual table. So what happened? Your views are logical table or logical entity because they are not occupy any space. That means they are not stored in memory, as well as those views are not occupy memory. That means view is only a visualization of your data, what you want to show or view to user, and that's why view are known as logical or virtual table or logical entity. So logical tables or views are based on one or more table or views. So you can create by using one or more table which are stored in your database, you can create view. And the definition of view is based on one or more table or views which are stored in your database. So you can use some tables which are stored in database to create a view. So if you use some table, then that table is known as base table. The table which is used to create a view, that table is known as base table. So this definition is also important. What is base table? What is view? So remember that the table which are used to create a view is known as base table. And our views are logical table, logical visualization. It cannot stored in your database. It cannot occupy any space, and that's why your views doesn't contain any data itself, because it cannot occupy memory. And if it cannot occupy memory, then how is that possible to contain any data in views? And that's why view doesn't contain any data itself. Your views are used for security purpose. If we have to provide some security to particular database, then we can use a view concept here. So how to provide security to any data? Let's see the example. I having a database student, and in that database I contains information of male student as well as female student. I want to show only female details to user or viewer. Then if I share the database which is student, then user can see male as well as female details, but I have to show only female details. Then what should I do? I create a view on that particular student table, and I apply a condition only female details are shown to user. Then only female details are viewable or disabled to your user, and that's why our view are used for security purpose. If you provide some security to particular data, then you can use views. I hope you understood why we use views. There is a question, why we use views concept in plsql, or what is the use of views? Then first use is security purpose. because views are display only selected data, and deselected data is select by using some SQL query, and only selected data is display by using view, and that's why we provide some security to your database. And those views are also known as stored selected statements. So remember that views are also known as stored selected statement. Views are also known as logical table. Views are also known as virtual table. So there are four names to your views. First is view, second is logical table, third is virtual table, and fourth is stored selected statement. Then what are the types of view? So there are four types of view. First is simple view, second complex view, third force view, and fourth one by one views. First is simple view. What are the simple view, or what is the definition of simple view? The view is created by using only one base table. Only one table which is present in your database. If we create view on that particular single table, then that view is known as simple view. Simple view is created by using only one table. Then what is complex view? Complex is opposite of simple. That means complex view are created by using more than one table. If we use more than one table to create a view, then that view is known as complex view. Then force view. If we create a view on particular table, but that table is not available in your database, then that view is known as force view. Table is not available in database, but we can create a view on that table. Then this is the force view. And last view is read only view. So what is read only view? Read only view is a view on which only read operation is happened. You can use only read operation on particular view. Then that view is also known as read only view. And views are fast executable as compared to your database tables, because tables are stored in database, but views are not. Views are executable fastly as compared to your database table, because tables are stored in database or some memory occupied by table, but views are doesn't occupy any memory. That means those views are not stored in your memory location, and that's why that time which will be saved, and that's why view's execution is fast as compared to table. So how to create a view? So look at here. Here is the syntax. Create view statement is used to create a view. So create view, then view name which you want to provide, and after that as keyword is used, and after that as keyword you can provide some PostgreSQL query. So look at here. Here is the another syntax which you identify easily. Create view name as select star from table name, after that where and any condition. So let's see the example how to create a view. So here is the table films available in your database, having three fields: field name, type, and release year. So there are four records in this films table. So we have to create a view on these films, because I have to display only comedy type films to user. So I create a view. So look at here. Create view statement is here. After that, comedies is the view name which will I provided. After that, as keyword, and after that I provide a SQL query to show only comedy type of films. So look at here. What is the query for that? Select star from films table. Here is the table name films. I have to select all records from films where is their condition type equal to comedy, which film having type comedy. I have to display all the records for that particular comedy type film. And for this query, I create a view name as comedies. And this is the view creation. And by using this comedy view, I provide a security to my films table, because I only display comedy films. Emotional and horror films details are secure from user. And to drop the view from your database, you have to only write command drop view, and after that your view name, which is comedies. So views are a carbon copy of your table, database table. So And look at here, if I added some values or some records in your table, film table, suppose I added particular record which having comedy type, then these record, then this view is, this record is automatically visible in your view because our view is comedy type and we have to insert a comedy type record in our film table. That's why it is automatically visible in view. And same, if we add some comedy type film in your view, that it is also visible in your table. But if I add some horror type film in my film table, then it will be does not visible in your view because our view is comedy type. And that's it for today's video. I hope you understood what is the view concept in your plsql. If this video is helpful for you, please do like to this video, also share with your friends because they also get help from this video. Haven't subscribed to my channel, so do subscribe to this channel. Also hit the bell icon for such new videos, because if you hit or press the bell icon, then you can get notifications of my videos when I upload the video. For watching this video, thank you so much, and stay tuned for next video because in next video we can see the cursor concept. Thank you so much.